In the last 5 years, I've helped hundreds of designers improve their Webflow websites, and I keep seeing the same mistakes over and over again. Here are the 14 most frequent Webflow mistakes I see and how to fix them. You might think Webflow columns are a great thing. They're not. They're terrible. Making them responsive is really painful. So instead, just use a flexbox and make your life easier. Most beginners forget to compress and resize their images. As a rule of thumb, you should aim to have images that are not heavier than 200 kilobytes. Use free online tools like TinyJPEG to reduce the weight of your assets. This will help your website load faster and therefore rank higher on search engines. If you have thousands of classes for the same types of elements, making changes afterward will be hell. Instead of treating every element as unique, try to style items with parent elements instead. Learn more about combo classes and spend extra time thinking about your names and reuse your classes. Too many designers jump straight into Webflow when they start a new website. Big mistake! Webflow is not made to design websites, it's made to implement them. Start by thinking about your content first. Add steps to your process to actually save time along the way. Beginners often forget that one class can be used in multiple places. So they make changes here and it messes up the design there. The best way to fix this is to design a style guide at the beginning of a project and stick to it. If you're duplicating a page more than 2 times, you'd benefit from setting up a CMS collection instead. And beginners tend to avoid using the CMS, but it's super simple to set up. It will be more effort upfront, but it will clearly pay off afterward. You won't have to duplicate and design everything again. Try to never have more than 12 words per line, just like in books. Don't put text in containers that are too wide, people won't read it. Put a max width of, say, 700 pixels and increase line spacing. Then your visitors will actually read what you write. Adding icons is a great way to help your visitors navigate your website and find relevant information. But these icons have to be on brand, and they shouldn't divert the attention away from the content. The Image Tracer plugin in Figma lets you convert an icon from raster to vector, which you can then edit easily. You should design your own icons so they fit your overall brand. Time out. I don't want to freak you out with all these mistakes. They're areas of improvement. Nothing's ever finished, and I'm sure your project is actually okay. It's going to be okay. You're a good person. Love Webflow. Love yourself. Everything's fine. All right, let's get back to it. Not designing success, empty, or error states is a missed opportunity to delight and help your visitors. We tend to forget them, but these states are crucial in your user experience. So go on and add nice and helpful messages in them. They'll help your website stand out. Don't start your project in mobile view. Otherwise, you'll have to style those elements again from mobile to desktop. When you're going downstream from desktop to mobile and you're using flexboxes and grids, making your website responsive is actually very fast. When designers come from other design tools, they're used to position things by just dragging elements around. That doesn't work on Webflow. Instead of positioning all elements one by one, with padding and margins and relative and absolute changes, just use CSS grids and flexboxes. Put everything in a flexbox and position elements that way. Beginners and pros make mistakes in Webflow all the time. It happens to everyone. But pros use the backup feature to rewind and work in short iterations. So use the backup feature and stop being afraid of breaking everything every time you make a change. To avoid overwhelming your visitors with too much information at once, add plenty of margins between each section. Your design will look immediately better. Start with too much margins, say 200 pixels, and then remove some if needed. The best websites leave plenty of space to make their content stand out more. Do not give access of your Webflow account to your clients or collaborators. If they want to make changes or give feedback, they should do so in the mockup, not in Webflow. Use the editor and collaborator features instead. I've put all the mistakes and solutions in one Webflow project that you can explore by yourself. Just open the read-only link and duplicate it if you need. I hope that was useful. Bisous.